Okay, here we are. Welcome back to my gaming table. We are in the middle of a game of Warfighter and struggling to get toward those drug huts. Before I start with turn 8, I need to address something. A couple of Board Game Geek members, Steve Cal and Hama, pointed out that when I was playing these terrain cards, for the entrance cost, I was paying cards, I was discarding cards in addition to paying the cost on the card. So, like for example, for Light Jungle, I discarded 4 cards. For Trail here, I discarded 3. And both of them wrote to me on the Geek and said, where did you get that rule where you'd have to discard cards for the entrance cost? And I picked up the rule book and thumbed through it and, that's a really good question. In fact, that was my reply to them. I have no idea where I got that, unless it was maybe I got them confused with paying the support cost to play certain cards like Speedball and Mortar Call, things like that. No idea. I really do not have a clue where that came from. I guess that's one of the hazards of playing a game solitaire all of the time is you get something wrong in your head and it never gets corrected, and maybe you even miss it when you reread the rule book or something like that. You get into a face-to-face game and that kind of thing is going to take care of itself. On the other hand, that's probably a good idea for making videos and post them for everyone to see, because somebody's going to catch your mistakes. So either way, it paid off. That's yet another asterisk that this game is going to have on it. Let's see where we are. We have a couple of guys on high ground, Light Jungle and a Trail, and they're currently in a battle with snipers, smugglers, and drug runners. And of course, we are headed for the drug huts. Let's start off with turn 8 and see how we want to play this out. Looking the board over, I think the first thing I'm going to do is, since Stevens is on the same card with Foster, and Foster has run his gun out of bullets, I am going to use the rule that says you may freely exchange or freely give ammo. So I'm going to give Foster all this extra 5.56 millimeter ammunition that I have been carrying, and we'll put the top on that, and so make sure it's we know he's empty there. So we're going to do that first thing. Now that that's done, Stevens is going to play this move out and perform a move without spending an action, and he is going to take that. So Stevens is going to move up onto the Trail. Since he has an entrance con or an entrance ability of 2, I need to discard a card, so I'm going to throw that camouflage card. And next thing that needs to happen is he is going to take an action and discard and draw, and he's not going to discard any, but he's going to draw 3, and then I'm going to use a hydration pack here and draw a fourth card. So we're just going to go 1, 2, another speedball, 3, snapshot, 4, and another move out, and never do anything what there's a But there's a purpose. So what he's going to do now is he is going to play this speedball card. Now he's going to need to pay the support cost of that, but we happen to have the AMPRC 154, which means we discard 2 less cards when playing a support card's discard cost. So we only need to lose 2 cards out of here, and I'm going to go with the cautious. And I better keep that other speedball the way that we're eating up information. And I'm just going to take the move out since we already played that. So those will be discarded, and I need to pay 3 experience points, and we'll have Foster. pay those. So I got 3 experience points in there to play that speedball. And now what I need to do is get 5 resource points of gear to distribute between everyone, because as you can see, Luce is getting low on shotgun rounds. Anderson is about out of the 5.56, and we're just getting low here. Okay, maybe my move in doing that wasn't so brilliant after all, because I could not use all the speedball points. And the reason I couldn't is because a lot of people are already carrying almost their maximum for the loadout. So here's what I did. I did 2 units at 5.56. I'm going to give 1 to Stevens because he started off carrying 1 anyway. And I've got 1 I'm going to give, actually I'm just going to give 5 to Anderson because he's already got 1 in his chamber and I don't want to exceed the limit there. And then, but I'll consider that 1 point as well. And then Luce is getting low on shotgun rounds, but he's still got 2 in there, so I purchased 4 and I just considered that 1 point. And so he's going to get topped off shotgun. Nobody else can carry much of anything. I was kind of hoping to get Foster and M67, but I'm no longer in the same hex as Foster was. So we have got that taken care of. Let's discard both of these since they don't need to be hanging around. Next thing I'm going to do is move Smith and Rowe up from high ground into the light jungle just to keep everybody together, and so we don't have an extra unnecessary reinforcement draw. So Smith has a movement of 4, and so he makes that transition easily. And Rowe has 3, which means I need to toss a card, and I will toss the snapshot and move him up. Actually, I better, before I start forgetting, is take off those actions for them. And now let's see about taking care of some of these bad guys. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to sick Luce on the smugglers. I'm going to play a prepared fire card, and I'll have Luce pay the experience points for that since I want him to be the one to do that. He needs a 5 to kill, and if he gets a kill, he gets an extra because of his point blank. So let's see if Luce can take one of these smugglers out. And we got a 4 and an 8, and I think that's going to do it. The smugglers have a cover of 2, and Luce needed a 5 with that shotgun for the kill. So we get flip that over for a kill, and then because he has that that ability here, he's going to spend another experience point and inflict a second kill. That is going to work out well for Luce now because he gets 3 experience points. So I'm going to drop 2 on there and flip that over to make the 3rd. Although I guess maybe since he was shooting at smugglers with a cover of 2, it wasn't such a smart thing to use a prepared fire. Probably should have saved that for the sniper, but oh well. And we're going to take an action there for Luce on that shot. And then let's just go ahead and have Luce take a whack at that sniper as well. Maybe he can roll again. Well, let's see what he does. Oh, come on. He gets a 5 and a 4. Not enough for the kill, but it is enough to suppress the sniper, which is the kind of stuff I want to see happening here. So Luce is used up here. Let's have Anderson fire a burst at the sniper and see if we can bring him down. And it's not going to do it. So that's Anderson's first shot. And let's have him fire another burst. See what kind of thing we can do. Nope. And Anderson runs out. Maybe it's my fault for telling him to shoot all the time. So that was a 2nd, and I'm going to spend a 3rd action and have Anderson reload. Now that was the clip he was already carrying. It's not one of the fresh ones. Not that it matters. All right, let's have good old Corona. Let's have him take a shot. He needs a five, and he's going to take a shot at that sniper. And okay, come on, come on, come on, come on. Okay, that's a six and a one. So that would be a kill, but no, it's just going to be a suppress on that sniper. These guys are hard to root out. Let's do one more on Corona. Two and a six, and that's going to be a suppress again, too. I think Samaniego is in there, and he can fire full auto and on a seven. So let's have him take a shot at the sniper. I want that sniper out of there. And that's a one and a ten. He rolled two ones, so he runs out of ammunition, and I'm just going to spend his last action and have him reload. All right, I'm going to have Smith take a shot at that drug runner, just to get him out of the way. He needs a six. For the kill, gets a nine. The drug runner is suppressed. One on the defeat cover. We'll have Smith take one more shot here. Cover defeated, but that's a suppress result again. So these guys are just blocking my way. It's mightily annoying me. Okay, time for Foster to use up some ammunition here. Might as well. He's gonna fire a burst. He's gonna need a nine at that range, but he's got a plus two. But he needs to spend an action and reload first. So that was what we're gonna have him do. Now, let's see what we can do against the drug runner. And let's see, he gets a seven, that's not enough, and it's not even enough for a suppress, that's a miss. We'll have him take another one. Firing these bursts. And he runs out of ammunition, so we're just going to spend another last action. And Roe is at range one and needs an eight. Let's have him give that a try. Roe needs a seven. A grunner gets an eight. The guy's suppressed anyway. He needs a three. That drug runner must be hunkered down real good. Have Roe take one more shot. And we got a four and a one. So yeah, he's suppressed real good. We just can't get past these guys. They're not going to be a threat on this hostile turn. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to spend Stevens' last action. And Stevens is going to draw up to seven. So let's see what we get here. Get an advance, combined fire. Get a steady aim and another prepared fire. Good, that sniper is going down next turn. That sniper is out of there. Time for the hostile turn. So first we do the reinforcement draw. We'll go to the light jungle. That reinforces on a zero, and that's a lookout. He doesn't go in. And on the trail, a zero or a one, and we get a two. So we continue to be lucky there. Now attack or close range, which a drug runner would do. He would close range and the sniper would attack. However, they are both suppressed, so they are not doing anything this turn. Now we remove their suppress markers and we just get to start this whole ordeal all over again. And we move now to time 11, and that makes it turn 9. Plan is to take that sniper out with this prepared fire card. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to have Corona make the shot, and he will pay the experience point to upgun that so he can use that card. And so basically I don't even have to roll that because we're looking for a defeat cover of six. So let's see if we can get that sniper out of the way here. And Corona rolls a nine. So this sniper is history. And Corona gets 3 points. So again, He spends one and gains three, so he's good there. All right, and now let's get that drug runner out of there, and let's have let's just finish with Corona here. Looking for a three and a five, and we got a seven and a six, so that drug runner is gone also. And Corona bags another point. We'll just flip that one over here, and he's out of the way too. And now we get to catch our breath here for a moment and think about what is coming next. Let me discard this and ponder the mysteries here. Stevens is going to discard and draw because we need to get a terrain card, so I'm going to spend that. I'm going to discard steady aim, combined fire, since we don't have a firefight, and I'm going to discard advance because I have on point. This would let Stevens advance into whatever terrain by bumping up his movement ability. However, if somebody goes in on point, we can play play this card and upgun it, and that will knock the entrance cost of the card down by four, and that will make it easier for Stevens to get in and Foster as well, because they're kind of slow pokes here. So that's what we're gonna do, is we're gonna throw those three here, and we're gonna drop four, and we gotta shake it off. Squad attack, squad entry, and steady aim. So no joy there, looking for terrain. Actually, I'm just going to discard all of these four. Yeah, we'll do this one more time. And this is the representation of scouting for terrain from the trail. I know there's terrain around here somewhere, Sarge. So, let's see what we got now. High grass. Okay, that's going to work. Now, I wonder if I play that and upgun it, if make it a minus one, if you get a refund on points. Just kidding, Dan. Two, and got a move out, and a suppress, and a cautious. Looking at this situation, we're going to be going into the high grass. The thing is that costs an action to play, and Stevens just used up all of his actions this turn to try and get this card. This also subtracts two from the next location's hostile value, so the next location may be a little bit easier to deal with, considering we've got on point, and then this the effects of this high grass. However, since we do not have anything more we can really do at this moment, it is time for the hostile turn. So it's time to draw up and see what it brings. First of all, we're doing the light jungle, which is a reinforcement of zero. Missed the rocket team with a two, and the trail is a zero or a one, and we get a watcher. They've got a two, so that ends that turn. No other hostiles on the board, and so we'll move that down to time 10, and that means we're on turn 10 now. So we're just rolling right along here. Okay, I have reset Stevens. I think he was the only one we had doing anything. Oh no, we had Corona. I need to reset him. Okay. So got him reset, and we got to play the high grass. So one action to play. Stevens is going to play that, and my newfound knowledge that it does not involve a card discard to play that, just one action, and I'm going to take a couple little cubes here to plunk down here and remind me that that's two off of the next location's hostile value. Now what we do is we draw up, and we're at 100 plus, so we got to go with 13 points, so let's see what we've got here. Got two, a hired muscle. Lookout, total of three. A drug runner for four. Seven with elite guards. Uh-oh, those guys are mean. Up to 10 now with ambushers. And those are going to go right there. And let's see, another three with smugglers. So we're up to 13. Let me get these guys kind of laid out. These guys are going to screen. They have a reinforcement at range zero, so We got quite a bit to deal with here. Here's the current situation. The hired muscle also pops up in the frontmost soldier location, so they're with the ambushers with everyone who's on the trail. The elite guards have an interesting mechanic. They get placed on the objective card, and they do not they just sit there until the objective is activated, and then they kind of wake up and fire. So that makes taking those drug huts out a little more interesting. And then we have everybody over here. I'm going to start out with having Luce take his M67 grenade, and he is going to throw it at the ambushers, just to see if we can get them out. So they take four dice, and they have a penetration of one, so that's added to the roll for defeat cover. Let's see what we get here. Okay, we've got a four. It needs a six to kill. We got a four, and a one, and a three, and a seven. So there is one kill and two suppress on that card. So adorn that accordingly. We'll take one of Luce's actions, and we will exhaust that M67. Next up, I'm going to turn Corona loose on the hired muscle guy and have him take that guy down. He needs a five to hit. Let's see if he can pave the way here. No, that was a clean miss. Come on, Corona. Let's try that again. And we got a three and a two. So at least the hired muscle is suppressed. This could get dangerous. Samaniago is going to shoot at the ambushers. He's going to go auto. Needs a seven for the kill. And what do we got here? We got a two, which does not defeat the cover. And he's a one, so he's just emptied the clip on them. He is empty. And let's see, we got a couple of fives on there. So nothing there. And I'm going to take that last action and have him reload. Man, nothing spoils your plans like running out of ammunition. I am going to have Anderson needing a seven. He's going to hit those ambushers. And we have a six and a ten. So another one is killed. No reload on that. So thank you, Mr. Anderson. And let's see if you can do that one more time. And send these ambushers to their maker. And we got a four, which defeats cover, and we got a nine, and no ammo roll, so no ammo out. So those guys are going to go away, and Anderson picks up 3 points of experience. All right. All righty. Let's see. I should probably take that. Okay, let's have Smith try to make a kill. Range one, he will need a six. And he nails this hired muscle guy. Sorry, it left my brain hired muscle, but didn't get out of my mouth. So anyway, Smith gets 2 points. And let's have him aim way far away into range two for his second action, and he needs a five, and he's going to go after that lookout. I don't like that lookout. And that's a one, but he suppresses, so the lookout is suppressed. That makes Joe a happy person. It is time to unleash the card I've been saving. We have lots of experience points built up between everybody, and we need to be able to spend them because I'm just about out of experience point counters, but that's kind of beside the point. So what I'm going to do is it's time to activate the mortar call. And what we need to do is I need to pay 4 for support, but since we have the AMPRC 154, that's 2 less, so I only need to discard 2 cards. I'm going to discard Move Out, and it probably would be a good idea to keep a defensive card. It's just a matter of which one. I'm going to discard the Suppress because the Cautious does the same thing. Well, no, I take that back. We'll discard the ammo from a self-defensive weapon. We'll work it out. Do I even have any self-defensive weapons? Does anybody have a self-defense? Oh. Well, nobody's carrying a sidearm today. Stevens gave up the sidearm for the knee and elbow pad so he could move faster. Oh, no, Foster has got one. So that might work out. All right. All righty. So we're going to do the mortar call. We're going to try and explode the smugglers in the high grass. So, going to attack that hostile card. We get a mighty 6 rolls, all the dice that I have out, plus the penetration, which gets a +1. So we need a 7. Every 7 or above kills a smuggler. This is exciting here, folks. And let's see what we got. Yeah, we got a 2, which defeats the cover. That's good. We have a 9. That's a dead. What did I say we needed? A 7. We got a 7. That's a dead. We got another 7. And that's 3 kills. So I think we blow them up really good. We're going to take them off. No experience points for blowing up the smugglers. And I just realized I forgot to put on the numbers for who they're going to attack this turn. But we've kind of finished them off, so I don't think that's going to affect it. If the drug runner makes it and the lookout makes it, I will. In fact, I'll just do that now. I just these guys pop up and I want to shoot at them so bad, and I forget to put the numbers on there, so it probably messed up the randomization somehow. We'll just the game has 3 asterisks on it. Let's just put another one on there. Who we got that can still do some damage here? It's up to Mr. Foster and his amazing self-emptying machine gun. So, Foster is going to take a shot first at the drug runner. He's going to fire a burst. He needs a 9, but he's got a +2. So let's see what he comes up with. He defeats cover. He rolls a 10. The drug runner is gone. So, he goes away. And let me give Foster a victory point. Thank you. And now let's see if he can do the same trick with that lookout. And he manages to suppress the lookout. And let's do that one more time. And he runs out of ammunition. I shouldn't have pressed my luck. I don't know. Rolling for Foster is like playing one of those press your luck dice games. It's just a matter of time before bad things happen to you. I think I'm going to have Stevens draw up just to be ready. And I think everybody else has done what they could. Roe is out of range, so Stevens is going to draw up. We're going to pull 4 cards here. We got an advance. I've got to move out. And I got to remember to point my camera properly. Let's see, what did I draw? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wetlands, that's going to come in handy. And let's see, since I want to keep that mortar call, I need to pay 4 experience points to retain it. However, since this is a deep raid, I pay 1 extra, so I need to pay 5. So let's just have Stevens donate, and he'll donate 1, that's 2, he'll donate 1, that's 3, he'll donate 1, that's 4, he'll donate 1, that's 5, and So we're going to retain the mortar call for another turn. It is now the hostile's turn. So let's draw for the light jungle. Reinforce of 0 and they pull a 1. That's nothing. And the trail is a 0 or a 1. We've been stuck there a while. I've got it memorized. And they get a thug. So we will see what the thug does. He will hit on a 5 or above. Let me draw a chit. He's attacking number 5. That means he's going to. Since 5 is in the light jungle, he's got a bead on our sniper, so he's not going to fire, but he's going to move. And that is why I keep row with Smith. The lookout is not going to do anything. He is suppressed. And that ends this turn. We move to 9, time event 9, and we are now going into turn 11. And at this point in the game, I am going to take a pause and edit and upload this, and we will see you in time for turn 11 when it comes.